uploaded to the Smerch missile have been used by Armenia. As a result of which, now we see the number of the casualties have been increased, and more than 3 houses have been destroyed. Using the cluster munitions against the civilians has only one sole purpose, to have an excessive casualties among the civilians, but once again demonstrating a true intention of Armenian side. Today, Minister of Defense of Armenia personally declared that Armenian armed forces will give a harsh response to Azerbaijan, but we have seen their harsh response was directed and targeted against Azerbaijani civilians, as a result of which 4 civilians have been killed and 14 have been seriously wounded. We do assess it as a war crime and military crime. It's an act of barbarism and vandalism, and all responsibility for these reckless and irresponsible actions are lying on the political military leadership of Armenia. It is once again demonstration of the fact that Armenian armed forces and political military leadership of Armenia is in a difficult moral and political situation, and that by doing such crimes, they are trying to take a revenge from Azerbaijani civilians. So far, since the start of this escalation from the side of Armenia and a war imposed by Armenia on Azerbaijan, 69 Azerbaijani civilians have been killed, 322 civilians have been seriously wounded. Armenia even resorted to the Sieta ballistic missiles and Scud missile against second biggest city of Azerbaijan, that is Ganja. Azerbaijan also has appealed to international non-governmental institutions, particularly Human Rights Watch and Amnesty International and other institutions, and to come and to see with their own eyes with the war crimes of Armenia on the ground, and to make a fact-finding mission about the use of the cluster munitions, including the dangerous Smerch and Scud and Tochka-U ballistic and reactive missiles against Azerbaijani civilians. As a sign of our commitment and respect to the humanitarian ceasefire, since the humanitarian truce that have been initiated by France on the 18th of October, we made a unilateral appeal and suggestion to Armenian side, we as international institutions, of returning the bodies of 30 Armenian soldiers and officers, and also rendering 2 Armenian civilians who are the elders beyond the 80s. And Azerbaijani government and Azerbaijan appropriate institutions provided all necessary medical and humanitarian support to these elders. They are in good and health condition. But so far, our appeal to Armenian side has been ignored. They even don't want to take their own bodies of their own soldiers. But today, we have taken unilateral action once again, talked to ICRC and also Office of the Personal Representative, the OSCE, that Azerbaijan brings the bodies to the border area along the Kazakh and Tovuz regions of Azerbaijan, from where to deliver the bodies and also with 2 elderly civilians to Armenian side. If they don't do that, we will render them to RCRC so that they can take it through the territory of the third country to Armenia. And also we see that Armenian armed forces are launching attacks against the positions of Azerbaijani armed forces from the sovereign territory of Armenia. Especially we witness it along the Zangilan and Gubatli regions of Azerbaijan. And Armenian political military leadership should finally understand that Armenian-Azerbaijani borders are running through Zangilan and Gubatli regions of Azerbaijan as well, which are the state borders of 2 countries. Any such attacks from the sovereign territory of Armenia is an act of military aggression or continuation of the act of military aggression from the Republic of Armenia against Azerbaijan. Azerbaijan armed forces refraining from any response to such an illegitimate military targets. But we are also retaining our right under the United Nations Charter, Article 51, for self-defense. If such attacks are committed against Azerbaijan armed forces, are causing casualties among the Azerbaijani civilians, we are retaining such a right of Azerbaijan. We do also think that such an approach and a policy from side of Armenia is a complete and utter disrespect by Armenia towards the political military institutions that Armenia shares a membership. According to the Treaty of the Common Collective Security Treaty Organization, all member countries should refrain from the use of force and threat of force against other neighbors. But Armenia misusing and misinterpreting and also demonstrating utter disrespect to this institution and its treaty-based legal obligations and using force from its own sovereign territory against the Republic of Azerbaijan. Azerbaijan has a closer and friendly relations with all CSTO member countries. Through our bilateral channels, we are also informing CSTO member countries about such actions, irresponsible actions of Armenia against Azerbaijan. And once again, I'm thankful to the military attachés for coming to our briefing, and we just try to provide operational update on the ground about the situation on the ground.